In this video, we're going to continue where we left off, answering questions pertaining to rational functions. We'd answered the first three questions, and now we're going to finish the next two. So I'd like to find the horizontal intercept. So to do that, we're going to replace the output with zero and solve for the input. This is the exact opposite of what we did for the vertical intercept. Remember, to find the vertical intercept, we replace the input with zero and solve for the output. Here, we're going to replace the output with zero. So f of x is our output. We replace that with zero. And we're solving for x, which is our input. Now, to solve this for x, you could cross multiply, right? We could do zero times the quantity of x minus 4. And we could do x plus 6 times 1. It would look something like this. Right, 0 times the quantity of x minus 4 and 1 times x plus 6. This becomes an algebra problem. Right, we distributed the 0 on the left side, and we were left with 0 equals x plus 6, and then I subtract 6 from both sides to leave me with x equals 6. Now, typically, I'm going to want to see the answer in the form of an ordered pair. So my input in this case was negative 6. My output was 0. What does this actually represent? What does this mean? Well, this is the place on the graph where the curve will cross through the x-axis. So at negative 6, 0, my curve will cross through the x-axis. So we've answered question number 4. Now we're going to move on to question 5. But before we do, again, I want to stress, please make sure you do not confuse asymptote with intercept. On all of my tests, I ask for both the vertical asymptote and the intercept. And I often have students confuse the two. So please make sure you take note and pay special attention to the words, intercept and asymptote. So let's move on. For question number 5, we're gonna find the equation for the horizontal asymptote. So for this, I'd like you to take out your TI graphing calculator. And let's actually graph this rational function. So press y equals. In parentheses, I'm going to do x plus 6. That quantity all divided by the quantity x minus 4. And I'm going to graph this in a 10 by 10 window. So I'm going to do zoom 6. Okay, that's not too bad. And we're asked to find the equation for the horizontal asymptote. So the trick here would be, if you press second and table set, it should bring you to this window, right? So I press second, table set. And I'm going to change, instead of starting at 25, I'm going to start at 0. And instead of counting by 1, I'm going to count by, say, 500. Now I press second table. Now you can see if I start at x equals 0 and start going down toward infinity or positive infinity, right? So as my x starts to get really big, what happens to my y? Okay, so at 500, I'm a little bit above 1. At 1,000, I'm at 1.01. At 1,500, I'm at 1.0067. At x equals 3,000, I'm at 1.0033. So as you can see, as x starts to get bigger and bigger, I get closer to 1 from above 1, but I never actually touch 1. So my curve is above 1, getting closer to 1, but never touches 1. If I arrow up many times and start to see what happens when x gets really negative, you can see I'm below 1, right? I'm at 0.98, 0.99004, 0.99335. As x is starting to get really negative, I come from below 1, getting closer to 1, but I never actually touch 1. And if I look at the graph, as x gets negative, so in this direction, x is getting negative, this line's going to come up and approach 1 from below 1, but never touch 1. here as x is getting really positive, right? Because if this is my x-axis and I'm going in this direction, x is getting bigger. So as x is becoming greater, I'm above 1, getting closer to 1, but I never actually touch 1. So that will be my horizontal asymptote. That is y equals 1. Right? If I were to draw an imaginary line at y equals 1, this curve would never touch 1, but it would approach it. And the same goes for this curve on the bottom. So we're asked to find the equation for the horizontal asymptote. It's simply y equals 1. So we've answered our 5 questions. Hopefully you're all pros at this now. Thank you for watching.